Hello and welcome to Tech Simplified TV. This is the third episode in VLSI Milestone series. Selection of gate material is a crucial point with respect to the performance of CMOS circuit. Initially, metal was preferred as gate material. Later on, polysilicon became the favorite, and further, industry has moved to metal again. Do you know why this shift? In today's episode, we will discuss about this journey of gate material from metal to polysilicon to again metal. Stay tuned if you are interested.
Let's take a look at the pointers we are going to discuss in today's episode. First, VLSI milestone and gate material. Second, what is polysilicon? Third, why polysilicon used as gate? Another slide on same topic, why polysilicon used as gate? Next, why self-aligned process is so preferred? Well, we will discuss about self-aligned process, that a very economical fabrication process. And since polysilicon is very much aligned with this process, so industry has selected polysilicon as gate material also. We will discuss on this point. And then poly depletion effect, and then high K material and polysilicon gate. So let's go to the first slide. VLSI milestone and gate material. This is the diagram we have coded in last two episodes, that is in SY and high K. This is high K metal gate. Timeline is 2010 and technology node is 32 nanometer. So before that, polysilicon was used. This list showing milestones for 25 years, 2000 to 2025. Before that, there was a time when aluminium were used as gate material. So over last few decades, CMOS process has seen a strange transition from metal gate to polysilicon gate and to again metal gate. In earlier days, aluminium was used as gate material. Due to advantages of self-aligned process, industry moved to incorporation of polysilicon as gate material. Well, self-aligned process is one reason. There are some other reasons also we will discuss in later slides. And with progressing node, again, a point came when polysilicon was not enough with that point. So then again, industry moved to metal gate. In today's episode, we will actually discuss about these two transitions and the reason behind them. We are done with this slide. Let's move to the next slide. What is polysilicon? This is monocrystalline, polycrystalline, and amorphous. Monocrystalline silicon is single crystal. Atoms are regularly arranged. And polycrystalline is when multiple monocrystalline creates polycrystalline. Or in amorphous, there is no regular crystalline structure. So polysilicon is also known as poly-SI, multicrystalline silicon, or polycrystalline silicon. Polysilicon, poly-SI, multicrystalline silicon, or polycrystalline silicon is a material consisting of number of smaller crystal or crystallites. Smaller crystal, multiple smaller crystal creates polycrystalline. Poly means many. It's made up of multiple small silicon crystal and is used in the solar and electronic industries. So polycrystalline silicon is very popular in solar industry since it's used in the production of solar cell, a key component in manufacturing solar panels. It has also found uses in various electronic devices ranging from small component to automotive controls. So polycrystalline silicon not only as gate material in CMOS, but also in solar cell making, it's a key component there. And there are three main methods to produce high quality polysilicon for use in different applications: the modified Siemens process, the fluidized bed reactor or FBR process, the upgraded metallurgical grade or UMG silicon process. By these three processes, polycrystalline silicon is made. We are done with this slide. Now let's move to the next slide. The reason why polysilicon used as gate. As we said, in early days, aluminium was preferred for gate material of MOSFET. Later on, polysilicon has gained preference. Reasons are, CMOS fabrication involves high temperature process steps. We all know that a MOSFET is fabricated and it consists of multiple steps. Mostly steps are high temperature process steps. So we need materials which can stand that high temperature. Now, polysilicon melts at 1414 degrees centigrade, whereas aluminium melts at 660 degrees centigrade. So polysilicon as a material more stable at higher temperature, that diffusion and anneals of silicon typically require around 1000 degree centigrade, causing any aluminium present during process to melt. Now, if we look at the process, these are the conventional process. First, silicon substrate is there, then these pores and drain. These two regions are created above the wafer that oxide is formed, and on that aluminium gate is formed. While forming aluminium gate in this way, it might not align appropriately with this gate zone. We need to keep this aluminium metal layer wide enough so that it cover this whole zone. It must be on the substrate between source and drain so that the channel can get created. Purpose is we will provide a bias here and it will pull the carriers to create a channel. That is purpose of gate. If it's not properly aligned, so if the field, generated field, electric field, which will pull the carriers, that function will get hampered. And many times these alignments doesn't remain proper. Look, it's slightly shifted on the left side. In this case, it's shifted in the drain side. That's a problem. Creation of mask and transferring layer properly on silicon is a very critical and expensive process. So by any means, if we could eliminate few steps, that is less cumbersome for us or less critical while making, probability of arising error is less. So it's basically beneficial in many ways. This one is basically self aligned method. Here in this method, first gate oxide is formed, second polysilicon gate is formed. While polysilicon gate is here, now diffusion and annealing process is done while creating the source and drain. Since polysilicon can handle that 1000 degree centigrade, which is the temperature of anneal diffusion, polysilicon gate is okay with that. Polysilicon gate is created here. Then this source and drain zone is created. Steps are reduced. We don't need to make polysilicon gates that much wide like aluminium gate. Polysilicon supports self-aligned gate development. In case of aluminium, gate source and drain must be formed prior to forming the gate, because these processes take place at 1000 degree and aluminium melts at 660 degree centigrade. Aluminium cannot handle that temperature. To assure the overlapping of gate to the source and drain, size of the gate is increased. Such misalignment of gate causes substantial variability. This gate must be made approximate 3 times larger than the space between source and drain to ensure that this whole region is spanned. This is the width of the zone between source and drain for that we are making so wide contact. This results in a slow device, the characteristic of which are strongly affected by the random misalignment of this gate element. In case of polysilicon, steps are less and these variability issues due to this misalignment and all, that's also gone. So these are 2 reasons. We have some more reasons. Let's see. We are done with this slide. Now let's move to the next slide. There is a band diagram. Why it's here? We will discuss it now. So first, undoped polysilicon has a high resistivity. It is doped in such a way that its resistance is reduced. Heavy doping of polysilicon generates highly conductive gates required to form the device. Metal is highly conductive. The difference between metal and semiconductor is that metal has many free carriers in normal temperature and it always has very high conductivity. But in case of semiconductor, we can control its conductivity by controlling the dopant. An intrinsic semiconductor, we keep on doping and its carrier concentration just get increased. We know that from basic of semiconductor. This controlling conductivity is the biggest benefit we get from semiconductor. Otherwise, in terms of conductivity, metal is much better. It has higher conductivity. We need conductivity, but at our will, so that we can control it. If we cannot control a system, we cannot use it in our benefit. Heavy doping of polysilicon generates highly conductive gates required to form the device. Now, polysilicon is a semiconductor, so its work function can be modulated by adjusting level of doping. Threshold voltage of MOSFET is related with the work function difference between gate and channel material. Gate material and channel material, there are work function difference. Work functions means this phi m, that is energy difference between Fermi level and vacuum level. Fermi level is dependent on the level of doping. Depending on level of doping, this one is variable. That is also variable. Two variable factors are there. So since both are variable, their difference is also variable. The work function of a semiconductor, Q5S, is the energy difference between the vacuum level and Fermi level, and that varies with the doping concentration for a given metal with a fixed work function, Q5M. Work function difference, Q5MS, Q5M minus Q5S, will vary depending on doping of the semiconductor. Work function of polysilicon can be varied with level of doping. So now we have a chance to vary this one. VTH has a dependency on Q5MS. So threshold voltage, we can control it using this doping. In case of metal, there is no doping concentration or anything which can be varied. When aluminum is there, it's always constant. One parameter is variable only. Here, two parameters are there which can be varied by us. That's another reason. With preceding nodes, device dimension reduced and their operating voltage is also scaled down. For such situation, low VT MOSFETs required. Polysilicon gate MOSFET has lower VT. Since highly doped polysilicon is used as gate material, its work function can be modulated by adjusting the level of doping. Now, fabrication steps with polysilicon are less. Fabrication process, especially mask creation and aligning, is a critical and expensive process. So, there are multiple reasons we got why industry selected polysilicon instead of aluminium. We are done with this slide. Let's move to the next slide. We have already talked about self-aligned process. Now let's know why self-aligned process is so preferred. The performance benefit, reduce the overlap capacitance. This gate is overlapping. This is the gate. Ideally, a gate must be like this only, right? Gate electrode is there to control phase between source and drain, not to source or drain. For them, source and drain electrode are there. Although in this method, there is overlap. That is not negligible. Overlap capacitance also there. Reduce the variability of overlap capacitance. If it's not aligned properly, like this, that overlap capacitance is changed. So not all MOSFETs are same on the chip, and among them, although they are manufactured in same run, in same node, because of this overlapping capacitance are variable, their performance is highly variable. Obviously, it's never possible to make two identical MOSFET. Still, there must be a range, and these range become wider. Reduce the threshold voltage of PMOS transistor being used in MOSFET as that time by 1.1 volt. We are talking about milestones. So it's not about now. At that time, threshold voltage was at this 1.1 volt. Now, work function difference between P-doped polysilicon gate and substrate, 1.1 volt lower than aluminium. That is another point. Lowered threshold voltage by 1.1 volt or 30%. VT is lowered as we move forward towards advanced node. So device dimension is shrinking. It's getting smaller, so VT is also reduced, because to turn on that smaller device or MOSFET, we need less voltage. If we substitute a material that must support that lower threshold voltage, polysilicon is aligned in that way. Increased speed by 3 to 5 times at same power dissipation. Reduced power by 3 to 5 times at same speed. So, speed and power dissipation, in both cases, it's giving benefit. Speed is increased, power dissipation is reduced. Substantially reduced variability in device performance. Reduced silicon area and cost by approximately 1/2. Gate area substantially reduced by smaller gate. This is a conventional one and this is the self-aligned method. So, gate area is reduced. Polysilicon used as local interconnect, increasing routability and reducing area. Polysilicon as a local level interconnect. What is local interconnect and what is global interconnect? We have already discussed in interconnect series, the first episode of it. Link will be provided in the description. Enable use of phosphosilicate glass, PSG, which require higher temperature processing. Inclusion of polysilicon has enabled use of phosphosilicate glass. That is also a beneficial point. Now we are done with this slide. Now let's move to the next slide. Poly depletion effect. Well, there are two Venn diagrams. Small error is there. This EC will be this, EF is this violet one, and EB is this green. Poly depletion effect, let's know about it. Undoped polysilicon has high resistivity. We know that highly doped polysilicon is a good conductor. A heavily doped film of polysilicon is used as gate electrode material, although we must consider them as semiconductor. Electrically active dopant concentration usually less than 1 into 10 to the power 23 per centimeter cube. That is the highest. polysilicon gate must be considered a semiconductor rather than a metal. It may be highly conductive. We must treat them as semiconductor. Now, this is N plus polysilicon, silicon dioxide. N plus polysilicon is stretched up to this, okay, total area. Here, P plus polysilicon stretch up to this area, okay. And now, this is P substrate, N silicon substrate. So, P substrate means N channel. So, to get N channel, we need to give here positive voltage and here negative voltage. Okay. In N plus polysilicon means highly doped polysilicon, majority carrier is electron. So when we are giving positive voltage here, so all majority electrons will move towards this zone. Okay. So here there will be lack of free carriers, or this zone which is part of polysilicon become depleted of electrons, and a zone which is depleted of free carriers behave like an insulator. It seems that silicon dioxide, that area has been extended, that is like a capacitor. This is a polysilicon capacitance and this is oxide capacitance. This comes into series and effectively, suppose oxide layer has increased, so VT will change. Same thing happens here. In P-type, it's N-silicon substrate means P-channel will form. So P-channel, that is positive type of carrier. To pull that, we need to give negative voltage here. While we are giving negative voltage here, the P plus polysilicon, its majority carrier is hole. Holes are pulled towards here and this zone is depleted of free carriers. Since this zone is depleted of free carriers, this zone is also behaves like a capacitor. Suppose that this oxide layer has increased. So, effective oxide thickness increases. So, polysilicon depletion effect is the phenomenon in which unwanted variation in VTH is observed when polysilicon is used as gate material. That leads to unpredictable behavior of electronic circuit. Threshold voltage is a very crucial parameter because switching happens depend on threshold voltage. So, obviously the circuit will not behave as we have already designed. Poly depletion leads effective increase of dielectric thickness and increase of threshold voltage. Because of these high K, dielectric or metal gate were introduced to solve the issue. Poly depletion is one reason why we have moved to high K dielectric metal gate. Another reason is also there, since we are going towards advanced node, device dimension were decreasing and silicon dioxide thickness also was decreasing and it was hitting a limit of few nanometer. The formula is C ox equal to epsilon ox or K and T ox, means we can increase C ox by either increasing this one or decreasing this one. So we cannot decrease or made the oxide layer more thin. So now we are increasing this parameter. We have changed the silicon dioxide. We are done with this slide. Let's move to the next slide. High K material and polysilicon gate. At smaller node, leakage in MOSFET is predominant. We have discussed it in first episode. On high K, higher conductivity in the gate also has become important as oxide dielectric layers cannot be shrunk any further to increase speed. As a result, dielectric material with high K value has used as gate oxide. So, polysilicon and high K material, till now polysilicon was getting used as a gate material. And now if we use it with high K, there are some problems were coming, like polysilicon and high K material interact at high temperatures creating salicides. This thin 1 to 4 nanometer layer have undesirable and unnecessary electrical impact on device performance. Polysilicon with high K metal creating salicides which is not necessary or desirable. So there are some impacts. The compatibility and integration of high K dielectric with polysilicon in existing CMOS process within appropriate thermal budget is one of the critical issues. To implement high K materials into sub 0.1 micrometer VLSI device fabrication, two materials are coming together side by side. They should be compatible to each other, should not react unnecessarily. Various interfacial reaction take place during poly deposition at high temperature, greater than 500 degrees centigrade. Now, interfacial reaction can be further enhanced during subsequent source drain anneal where temperature rise up to 1000 degrees centigrade. integrate in CMOS processing. Poly gate is deposited first and then source and drain zone are created and then annealed at high temperature like 1000 degrees. Well, that temperature level, they are not compatible with each other. Their integrity doesn't remain same and they create salicide. Another issue with polysilicon high-k combination is that threshold voltage become unacceptably high. We are moving towards advanced node and high-k and polysilicon, this combination will give a high threshold voltage that is not acceptable. So as a result, metal gates are used with high-k dielectric CMOS processing. Now we have already discussed on high-k dielectric and metal in our first episode of this series, that is VLSI Milestone series. Links are provided in the description. Please watch it. We are done with our discussion on this topic. Thank you for watching up to this point. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe. In case you have any dislike, put it as a comment. If you have a question or query, put it as a comment. Thank you again and bye for today.